三宝。
The three treasures for new now receivers.
他人的一生中有许多值得庆贺的事情，但却有更多无价且必须要全力以赴来追求的东西。
There are many things in life worth celebrating. However, there are even more priceless things worth pursuing with all our efforts.
2500多年前，当释迦牟尼佛仍是王子时，亲眼目睹了人世间之生老病死，他告诉自己一定要找到一条永恒之路，于是他放弃了王位及荣华富贵，四处去找寻名师及永久解脱的法门。后来燃灯古佛为他受记，最后他修成了正果，也留下了许多的经典，引导众生开悟正果。
About 2,500 years ago, when Sakyamuni Buddha was still a prince, he witnessed the four sufferings of life, birth, old age, sickness and death. He told himself, I've got to find the way that leads to eternity. Thus,He gave up his throne and fortune in search for an enlightening master and the way to eternal liberation. Later, he was initiated by Dipankara Buddha and eventually reached Buddhahood. Sakyamuni Buddha's teachings were collected by his disciples as sutras.The large collection of sutras have continued to guide sentient beings even till this day.
在一般人的思维里，极有价值、罕有又很不容易得到的东西，而且是人类所一直在追求的，我们才会称之为宝。今天您在上天的恩典及诸佛菩萨的祝福下求了道，得了三宝。这道就是当初佛陀及无往经来的修行者宗教家倾一生之力所追寻的永恒之路。过去因为天时未至，道是单传独授，得道者稀，修行者常有踏破铁鞋无觅处之憾。如今上天慈悲大开普渡，得道者众，求道者可说是得来全不费功夫。虽然得道容易，也是自己累世佛缘根基深厚，祖上有德所致，所以当您求完道时，大家都给您道喜。
Generally, we call a precious, valuable, and rare item which is highly sought after as a treasure. Today, because of the grace of heaven and the blessings from all Buddhas and Bodhisattvas,You have received Dao and the three treasures. Dao is the way to eternity that Sakyamuni Buddha, countless cultivators, and religious people have been searching all their lives. Before 1930, Dao was transmitted on a one-to-one basis.An enlightening master could only transmit Dao to a one-qualified individual because the timing for universal Dao transmission was not ripe. The number of people receiving Dao were scarce due to the lack of opportunity to meet with an enlightening master and receive Dao. What a pity! Because of the grace of heaven, now is the time for universal Tao transmission, and therefore, many people had the opportunity to receive Tao. Although it may seem relatively easy to receive Tao, receiving Tao is actually based on your affinity with Buddhas, your deep spiritual foundation, and the beneficence of your ancestors. Thus, after you had received Tao, everybody would express their heartfelt joy and congratulate you.
依照三宝来修行的话，可以帮助我们。第一，跳脱生死轮回；第二，净化我们的业力，改变命运；最后，返回天上的故乡。
Practicing the three treasures can truly help us in the following ways. 1. Transcending the cycle of life and death. 2. Cleansing our karma, changing our destiny, and eventually returning to our heavenly home.
一般的人由于业力的牵引，不得不再苦来到这世界上，每来一次就会造些业，漫漫的人生路上总是有着诸多的不如意、抱怨、忧愁、烦恼、病痛等。面对命运的枷锁与生死的轮回，却不知所措，更无法跳脱出来，实属无奈。
Because most people's destiny are led by their karma, they have to go through the cycle of life and death repeatedly without choice. Each cycle of life and death would accumulate some karma, good and bad. Therefore, their long journey of life would be filled with different kinds of complaints, worries, annoyances, sickness, and sufferings. Life's journey is never what we expected. Most people are imprisoned by fate and trapped in the cycle of life and death. They feel helpless because they failed to find a way to become liberated.
我们人的身体只是灵性暂时居住的房子，当生命旅程结束时，灵性会脱离身体进入另外一个世界，而求道时得到的三宝就是回天的凭证，这也是人生中最重要的一件事。以下事项是需要您放在心上的，亦不要忘记三宝，也不可以泄露三宝。二，不反道爱德；三，多了愿，多行功立德。如此，我们才可以回天上的故家乡。
Our physical body is a temporary home for our soul.When the journey of our life comes to an end, our soul will leave the body and enter another world. The three treasures you have received are the token for returning to the heavenly home. They are the most important things in our lives. The following are the three main points that you need to keep in mind.1. Do not forget and disclose the three treasures. 2. Do not do anything illegal, immoral, or harmful to yourself and others. 3. Do as much as you can to fulfill your vows and accumulate merits and virtues. By following these three points, you will be able to return to the heavenly home.
现在让我们来简单地介绍一下三宝。
Now, Let us briefly introduce the three treasures.
第一宝，玄关窍，灵性进出的门户。
The first treasure, heavenly portal, the main gate to our true nature / true self.
在庄严神圣的修道仪式中，便传师在我们的玄关窍这么一点，点燃了自性之光明，当下玄关窍立刻现出了如同绿豆大小般之佛光。我们可以看一下各宗教圣人的画像，每位圣人之头骨都有一个光圈，此光乃是自性之光，借着后续的修行及行功立德，此佛光会逐渐扩大，最后就像各教圣人的光圈一样地光亮圆满，展现出来的智慧及德行随着因缘愿力而自处利益众生。
During the solemn and holy now receiving ceremony, now transmitting Master want at our heavenly portal to illuminate the light of our true nature.A small halo will radiate from the heavenly portal immediately afterwards. If we look at the portraits of the saints from different religions, we will see that they all had one thing in common, which is the halo behind each saint's head. The halo is the light emitted from the true nature.The halo will expand in accordance with our cultivation and accumulation of merits and virtues. Eventually, our halos can be as round and bright as the halos of the saints. Then, the wisdom and virtue we exhibit will accompany our vows and affinities to benefit all mankind.
玄关是一个正门，也是修心的下手处。行住坐卧之中，常收束身心，从玄关发出之念头，都是正念、慈悲心、喜舍心、智慧心。心提心念在玄关，在用玄关去听、去看、去应对一切事物，便能与佛菩萨以心应心。
Heavenly portal is the main gate of our body. It is also the starting point for us to cultivate our heart. Every day we need to manage our mind and body properly.Each and every thought from the main gate is righteous because it is full of mercy, compassion, joy, giving, and wisdom. Focus our mind slightly on the heavenly portal and use this focused attention to listen, look, and deal with everyday matters. Then,We can unify our heart with the heart of Buddha and Bodhisattvas.
我们求道是了解我们有个真主人，真主人也是住在我们的家里面，每间房子都会有主人的房间，主人有主人该睡的地方，客人有客人该睡的地方，这不能错乱的。
Receiving vows to help us recognize the true master. Our body is like a house. Now, we know that this true master lives in our house. Every house has a master bedroom. The master bedroom is the room where the master sleeps in guests.Have to sleep in the guest rooms because only the master should sleep in the master bedroom. This arrangement should not be altered in any way.
各教 道经典也有关于玄关之论述。子曰，谁能出户有虎和莫由思道也，每个人要走出房子都要经由门户。的肉体由如果宅，修行者欲走过此火宅之束缚，何不走这一条光明大道呢？
The classics, sutras, and scriptures of different religions all contain descriptions of the heavenly portal. Confucius said, who can go out without using the door, so why doesn't he anybody follow the way? Now everyone gets out of the house through the door. The physical body is like a burning house. A cultivator needs to take the correct and bright path in order to break free from the confinement of the burning house.
圣经里也提到，
Testimonies of the heavenly portal can also be found in the Holy Bible.
眼睛就是身上的灯。
The light of the body is the eye.
你的眼睛若了亮，全身就光明。你的眼睛若昏花，全身就黑暗。你里头的光若黑暗了，那黑暗是何等大呢？
The lamp of the body is the eye.If therefore mine eye be single, my whole body shall be full of light.
马太福音
Matthew 6:22, but if thine eye be evil, my whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is the darkness?
马太福音
Matthew 6:23, the lamp of thy body is thine eye. When thine eye is single, thy whole body also is full of light. But when it is evil, thy body also is full of darkness.
路加福音
Luke 11:34,
你只有一只眼睛入永生，强如有两只眼泪丢在地狱的火里边。
It is good for me, you, to enter into a life with one eye, rather than having two eyes to be cast into the hell of fire.
马太福音
Matthew 18:9,
试问是用左眼还是右眼上天堂进入永生呢？肉眼早晚会毁坏的，如何使人上天堂呢？
After reading the above verses, some questions may arise. For example, should we enter heaven and attain eternal life through the left eye or right eye, since the eyes of this physical body will deteriorate one day? How can they help us return to heaven?
玄关窍已被解开后，好好地修持，久而久之，身体内外真的会光明，连毛细孔都会发出光来，尤其是真修持练得到清闲闲，只是我们的肉眼看不到而已。
Once the heavenly portal is opened, if we cultivate vows sincerely for some period of time,Then both our internal and external body parts, including our pores, will be luminous. This is true for all members who have cultivated sincerely and truthfully. However, the light or halo emitted from the body cannot be seen with the naked eye.
佛经也提及，无有正法眼藏。涅槃妙心不立文字，教外别传解释问， 佛陀所言之正法是常在左眼或右眼呢，或是第三之真理，眼修过道的人就很清楚答案了。
In the Buddhist Sutra, Sakyamuni Buddha also said, There is the true Dharma in my eye, there is no form, there is no word for it.So where is the true Dharma hidden? Is it hidden inside the left eye or right eye? Or is this Dharma hidden inside the third eye, the eye of the truth? The answer is very clear for any Tao receiver.
儒家所说的君子圣其无也，指的也是我们的自性佛性是无一无二的，来自上天，要善加戒慎保护，莫让它受到污染。慎独的功夫，简单的说，就是存好心，说好话，做好事，以及诸恶莫作，众善奉行，精进永恒地藏道前进。
In the Confucian classics.A noble person needs to be cautious with the one. The one is referring to our true nature or true self, which is unique and came from heaven. We need to be cautious by protecting it from pollution. In other words, we need to keep a good heart, say good words, and do good things.We need to do all good deeds continuously with all our efforts.
一个人若平日能够时常守玄，祥和之气自然会引发善因缘的发生。佛像尚未开光，佛没有被请入，爱它是没用的，那一尊佛不会接受。你本身就是一尊佛，要开光，要求道，求道就是开光，告知你真主人在哪里。
If a person can keep his mind focused on the heavenly portal constantly, then the peaceful energy emitted from him may attract or accumulate good affinities.A Buddha statue needs to be initiated so the spirit of the Buddha will be invited into the statue. Otherwise, it doesn't matter how often you worship the Buddha, he will not accept your worship. You, yourself, is a Buddha. Therefore,You need to be initiated by opening up the heavenly portal. How can the heavenly portal be opened? It can only be opened through the Tao receiving ceremony. Receiving Tao helps us to rediscover the location of our true master.
我们平常时候精神是外放，眼要看，耳要听，吃进去的营养也一直在消耗，手拳有助于减少营养与能量的消耗，同时让更多营养转为能量运行于身体，让末落抗风，减少病痛，促进身体健康。
Every day a lot of our energies and spirits are wasted on the things we see with eyes, we hear with our ears, we think with our mind, etc. Thus, the nutrition for our bodies is constantly being used. When we calm down and focus on the heavenly portal,It helps to lower the energy and nutrition consumption of our bodies. At the same time, it helps to turn more nutrition into energy, transport the energy throughout the entire body, and make the energy channels freer so that the energy can flow with less obstruction. If energy can flow freely, then we would not get sick so easily. As a result, our health would improve.
第二宝，口诀五字真言。
The second treasure, heavenly mantra of five words.
念五字真言，不是外求净土，而是内生净土。口诀又名五字真言，口之修养也。口轻而诱人，骂人则口不轻，实浊者口不轻，言实以正有道也。
Reciting the heavenly mantra silently will lead us to the inner pure land within ourselves instead of the pure land on the outside. The heavenly mantra is also called the five words. It is used for the cultivation of the mouth. Benevolence is expressed through a pure mouth.If one curses and consumes impure food, then his mouth is considered to be foul. Therefore, if you say good words and consume pure food, then you can become one with Tao.
第一个字，无疾无对待之真理世界一庆佛性自性。先我二儒家中庸之天命之谓性，也就是说，我们都是老母的分灵，都是兄弟姐妹。
The first word means Wuji. It is the world of absolute truth with no opposites. It can be explained as one power, true nature, mood and nature, true self.Two, in the doctrine of the me, what heaven or heavenly nature confers is called true nature. In other words, our spirits came from heavenly nature. In the sense, we all are brothers and sisters because our spirits all came from the same origin.
第二个字，太极有阴阳相对待。诸如日夜、善恶、高矮等，也可以理解成一人心二儒家之率性之谓道人们的心思是错综复杂且迷惑的，因此需要依循着上天所赋予之纯善的天性走在正道上。
The second word means Taiji. It is the world of duality. Duality consists of having two opposites such as the sun and moon, day and night, good and bad, tall and short, etc. It can be explained as one power mind, three in the doctrine of the me.In accordance with true nature is called the way, Tao. The human mind is complex and often filled with confusions. Therefore, we need to follow the true nature from heaven and take the righteous path.
第三个字，黄极物质的现象世界，它不是永恒不变的。也可以理解成一人身二儒家中庸之修道之谓教。
The third word means Wangji. It is the world of physicality which is the one we live in. Nothing in this world is permanent. It can be explained as one power physical body, two in the doctrine of the me.Cultivating the way, Tao is called education.
要走在正道上，是需要有正确的教育与引导的点。
In order to be on the righteous path, we need to have the correct education and guidance.
请听真言 坚持一贯的性在心思万己生命万能性去心思尽失生命不动一句此诗而已。
Our true nature, mind, and body are one. Without the true nature, our mind and body are useless.
第四个字是放出去，无所不在。
The fourth word means permeating. The greatness of our true nature can permeate the universe.
第五个字是收回来，回到玄关窍底。
The fifth word means contracting. Our true nature can contract and return to the heavenly portal.
我们的自信是无所不在的，而且自信是没有分别、没有对待的，才称为无极。无到极点就是没有分别对待。
Our true nature is everywhere. It is absolute. It doesn't discriminate or judge. Thus, it is also known as Muji, which means genuine emptiness.
弥勒也有慈爱之意，修行上让慈爱不满的宇宙，就如同老母及诸佛菩萨对众生的爱是没有空间的限制的。
The fourth and fifth words can be combined to mean mercy and loving kindness. As we cultivate, we learn to love all things in the universe with mercy and loving kindness just like Baolamu, Heavenly Mater, Buddhas, and Bodhisattvas love all sentient beings without spatial limitations.
常念五字真言，你就与弥勒祖师济公活佛老师有感应，遇困难时感应就快，心不平静时默念五字真言，有问题时静不下来时默念五字真言，就有妙智慧。当念到慧心不乱时，意志可穿越时空，直入佛之愿力之间，让能量发挥到极致。
By silently reciting the heavenly mantra often, you will create a strong bond with Maitreya Buddha and Jigong Living Buddha. Then come whenever you encounter some difficulties, Buddhas will get the signal more quickly. When you feel uneasy or disturbed,recite the heavenly mantra silently in your heart, then your great wisdom may arrive to help you resolve any difficulty. And when you silently recite the heavenly mantra with full attention, your willpower can permeate through time and space, and enter the power of Buddha's vows. Then,The strength of the mantra will reach ultimate attainment.
孔老夫子说过，人莫见于流水，而见于止水。诚心专注一念诵五字真言，有助于内心的平静祥和，更清楚地看清自己，遇到事情时能做出更正确的判断与决定，并更有效地完成工作任务。
Confucius said, men do not look into a running water as a mirror, but into still water. Silently reciting the heavenly mantra with sincerity and full attention helps to pacify our mind. As a result,We can see ourselves more clearly, make judgments and decisions more correctly, and complete daily tasks with more efficiency.
第三宝，和同学习宽恕。
The third treasure, heavenly hand sign learning to be forgive.
受报和同也意味着与天佛和与天佛同，把我们的佛心、自性、愿力和诸佛菩萨的佛心、自性、愿力相合在一起。我们和同修之间要和，才能同人与人之间要和，要同，就要学习树道，也就是己所不欲，勿施于人，学习宽恕，就像耶稣在十字架上所说的话，就是一种宽恕。人与人之间多一些体谅宽恕，才能和，才能同。若小同都无法做到，如何世界大同呢？此受应也是回天的一个凭证。
Holding the heavenly hand sign means to unify our true nature with Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. It is the unification of our true nature and bows with the true nature and bows of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Similarly, we need to unify with all people including other Dao members by getting along with them.We need to learn to be more cooperating, understanding, tolerating, and forgiving, so we can form a perfect union. Confucius said, Do not do unto others as you would not have others do unto you. The last words of Jesus Christ were also words of forgiveness.In order to form a perfect union with others, we have to be more understanding and forgiving. If we cannot form unity with the people in our society, how can we form unity with the rest of the world and achieve great harmony? The heavenly hand sign is also a token for returning to the heavenly home.